5 seconds to go. Start. This court recollects its decision in Era versus State and City of Delhi, where the mischief rule was commended and applied specifically in relation to POXO. Together, the mischief which Parliament wished to eliminate, it would be necessary to briefly trace the history of the law which existed before POXO was enacted. The Indian Penal Code, IPC hereafter, criminalizes assault or use of criminal force which outrages a woman's modesty by Section 354. The expression criminal force is defined in Section 350 and assault is defined in Section 351. These require an element of application of physical force to women. The expression modesty was another limitation, as older decisions show that such a state was associated with decorousness of women. This added a dimension of patriarchy and class. One cannot be unmindful of the circumstances in which these provisions were enacted by a colonial power at a time when women's agency itself was unacknowledged or had limited recognition. Further, women in India were traditionally, during the time of enactment of IPC in the mid-19th century, subordinated to the care of their fathers or their husbands or other male relatives. They had no share in immovable property. Notions of gender equality were unheard of or not permitted. Women had no right to vote. Quite naturally, the dignity of women, or indeed their autonomy, was not provided for. The advent of the Constitution of India revolutionized, at least in law, all that, regardless of gender, race, caste, religion, or region, or all of the acknowledged sectarian and discrimination enabling barriers, everyone enjoyed equality of law and equal protection of law, Article 14. Further, the provision in Article 15(1) prescribed discrimination by the state in all its forms on various grounds, including gender. Article 15(3) enabled the state to enact special provisions for women and children. The limitations in law in dealing with acts that undermined the dignity and autonomy of women and children, ranging from behavior that is now termed stalking to pornography or physical contact and associated acts which were not the subject matter of any penal law, were recognized, and appropriate legislative measures adopted in other countries. These have been alluded to in Trivedi's judgment in detail. These laws contain nuanced provisions criminalizing behavior that involve unwanted physical contact of different types and hues, have the propensity to harass and discomfit women and minors, including minors of either sex, or demean them. The 172nd report recommended changes to the definition of rape, expanding its scope and also incorporating the expanded definition of sexual assault. These and India's ratification of the UN Convention on the Rights of Children 1992, which required nation states to adopt suitable legislation to combat coercion of children in sexual activity, exploitative use of children, and children's exploitation for pornography formed the background and basis for enacting POCSO. The Statement of Objects and Reasons for POCSO cites the UN Convention and further states that the data collected by the National Crime Records Bureau shows that there has been increase in cases of sexual offences against children. This is corroborated by the study on Child Abuse India 2007 conducted by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. Moreover, sexual offences against children are not adequately addressed by the extant laws. A large number of such offences are neither specifically provided for nor are they adequately penalized. The interest of the child both as a victim as well as a witness need to be protected. It is felt that offenses against children need to be defined explicitly and countered through commensurate penalties as an effective deterrence. It is therefore proposed to enact a self-contained comprehensive legislation inter alia to provide for protection of children from the sexual offence and pornography with due regard for safeguarding the interest and well-being of the child at every stage of the judicial process, incorporating child-friendly procedures for reporting, recording of evidence, investigation and trial of offences and provision for establishment of special courts for speedy trial of such offences. Parallelly, it would be useful to notice that the IPC was sought to be amended through the introduction of a bill in 2012 which for some reason did not see the light of the day. Instead, the amendments were made through an ordinance which was later replaced by a parliamentary act. Stop.